What's up guys, Sal here. So Samsung has officially unveiled the processor that is gonna power its upcoming flagship phone, the Galaxy S11. The Galaxy Unpacked event is still 4 months away, but the processor that is gonna power the S11 devices in Asia, Europe, and other parts of the world, except for the US and China, is already here. The specs of this new chipset give out some key specifications of the Galaxy S11. So without much further ado, let's jump right into it. The new Exynos 990 supports displays of up to 120Hz refresh rate. Yes, Samsung has changed the naming scheme a little bit. It's 990 instead of the 9830. Nonetheless, the presence of a 120Hz refresh rate display driver doesn't necessarily mean the Galaxy S11 will surely have a 120Hz display. No, it doesn't work like that. Samsung has to take into consideration of their counterpart Qualcomm's Snapdragon processor whether or not that chip supports the 120Hz display. But in any case, I can assure you one thing. If not the 120Hz, the Galaxy S11 will surely have at least 90Hz display. You can count on me on this one. A higher refresh rate makes a night and day difference. Once you go 90Hz or 120Hz, you can't go back to 60Hz. It looks really choppy. I just hope though, unlike some company which only activates 90Hz based on the screen brightness, Samsung does a better job and implements the 90Hz or 120Hz when it's necessary and not on the basis of the screen brightness. Finally, the LPDDR5 RAMs are gonna be mainstream and the Galaxy S11 is gonna be the first smartphone to have it. LPDDR5 RAMs are 30% faster than LPDDR4 RAMs that we can find on devices like the Galaxy Note 10 Plus, iPhone 11 Pro, literally every flagship of 2019. The advantage of this new RAM is that it will enable ultra-high definition video recording and AI-powered machine learning features with substantially improved device battery life, drawing 30% less power compared with LPDDR4. In other words, the Galaxy S11 should expect to see not only speed and battery life increases, but dramatic jumps in the quantity of memory. 12GB of RAM is gonna be the base just like the Galaxy Note 10 Plus, unlike some company which still offers only 6GB of RAM in 2019. Yes, the new chipset supports camera modules of up to 108MP sensors. Again, this doesn't necessarily mean the Galaxy S11 will have 108MP camera. There are some rumors though that it could come with this camera setup, but still I would advise to wait for further information before actually believing it, because usually Samsung doesn't include higher megapixel cameras in their flagships. These higher megapixel cameras go into their mid-range phones, so let's see how things plays out this time. Samsung says the dual-core neural processing unit can perform over 10 trillion operations per second, which is twice as much as fast as Apple's A13 neural bionic engine. This basically means the artificial intelligence on the Galaxy S11 is going to be really powerful and will perform better than their 2019 flagships. There was a rumor a few weeks ago that Samsung might drop their custom cores in favor of ARM's architecture, but that turns out to be false. The Exynos 990 will use two custom M5 cores that are really powerful, four Cortex A76 cores and two power efficient A55 cores. It's built on 7nm EUV process and they are using Mali GPU again, which they say is 20% faster than Exynos 9825's GPU. That being said, this new chipset will go into mass production in December and will end up on the Galaxy S11. Samsung will use the Snapdragon 865 in the US, China, and some other countries. To keep up with all the Galaxy S11 updates, please be sure to subscribe. And as always, I'll see y'all tomorrow. Peace out.